introducing us. This is a podcast from Moscow Institute of Semiconductor Physics, Department of Theoretical Physics. We are thankful for opportunity to present our recent results, which are not published yet, on dynamic conductivity of dot graphene in a high electric field, and we have investigated theoretically its dispersive properties. Regarding motivation, we can stress the advances in graphene structures, measurements, and device applications in strong electric field provide the importance of key dispersive dynamic response. That is, the linear response to external small electromagnetic waves depends not on the frequency, but also on the K vector. And this is important for the current technology achievements. Examples, not all, but some of them, are listed below. And surely this is a different type of tips. This branch of physics now is one of the well-established tip-based optical nanoscopy. Then, of course, ultra-short beams, scanning spectroscopy technique, and so on. Also, different types of patterning due to technology achievements, such as gratings or metal particles, which are dipoles or graphene interacting with incident electromagnetic wave. And at last, an interesting example demonstrated recently is coupling light into graphene plasmas with optical gradient, which is formed by surface acoustic waves, which are electrically generated by piezoelectric field. And the common feature in all these examples is that there is a characteristic feature size that is translated into, into the K dispersion of the dynamic conductivity. Here we demonstrate our geometry of our problem, and on the left you can see the graphic single layer on the substrate, and the coordinate shift system chosen so that the axis is perpendicular to the graphic layer. The graphene layer is lying in the XY plane, and the total electric field is composed, it is demonstrated on the left, of a strong DC field designated as E0 and a small AC field varying across time and space. And to calculate the dynamic conductivity, we need just to calculate the AC current, and the dynamic conductivity is simply the kinetic coefficients, which is proportionality between the current density and the electric field. On the right, we just demonstrate our important vectors, which are the gain vector we choose. It is along the x-coordinate axis, and the other features vectors are the electric field, the AC field, and the current corresponding to AC transfer designated as J1 and E1. And at last, the DC field produced the drift velocity in the electron system, drifting as a whole, with the drift velocity designated by ED. Also, we demonstrate the characteristic angles formed between these vectors and K vector. To make our theoretical model as general as possible, we will treat the basic vectors. This is the amplitude of AC field, the K vector, and the frequency. They are our parameters, and we will be considered them as independent parameters. Asking the question, what is expected? First of all, we achieve the anisotropy of the dynamic conductivity because we have two preferable directions formed by the K vector and the vector of applied DC field. Next, the dynamic conductivity activity of this phase is a book extension. We intend to calculate both the real part sigma prime and the imaginary part sigma double prime. But in this report, we concentrate mostly on the real part of dynamic conductivity. Why? Because we are interested in possible instability regions on the high DC electric field. And we investigated two kinds of possible instabilities. Well, one is due to well-known Chinnikov effect in the drifting electron gas. And the criteria for this instability is that if drift velocity is greater than the phase velocity of the electromagnetic wave, then the energy from electrons can be transferred to the wave, thereby to amplify it. We are interested in most high frequencies, light materials, variables. So we go to the AC transport region without collisions. And in this regime, it is well known so-called kinematic resonance, when the electron velocity coincides with the phase velocity of the electromagnetic wave. But due to the characteristic feature of electron velocity graph, which is independent of the momentum, the three-dimensional space shown here is divided by the linear dependent of frequency on the wave vector, which is for the three-dimensional surface of a cone formed in the three-dimensional space. K can be treated as a two-dimensional vector. And this resonance is very sharp inside the cone formed with this surface. There is no resonance vector, so the real part of the dynamic conductivity should be zero, and outside this cone they are not zero, and this is the region where we are working on. The main body assumptions are illustrated here, and we use the quasi-classical approach based on the Boltzmann magnetic equation. And due to the linearity of the AC problem, we can separate the transfer into two independent parts. We can give steady-state transfer and small signal high-frequency transport independently. Regarding steady-state transport, we will use well-justified program approximation based on the shifted distribution function in the momentum space, and it is described by the three parameters shown here. This is the electron temperature, drift velocity, and Fermi energy, which are determined by the proper equations for balance equations. Regarding the AC transfer, we go to the most high frequency and neglect the collision integral on the right of this equation. And then this equation is reduced to so-called plasma equation, which has analytical solution. So we can give, so to speak, to have simultaneously. Firstly, we can go to highest frequencies, and secondly, we can obtain all formulas almost analytically. This is the basic formula. And you can see that electron transport enters to this formula through the steady state distribution function at zero, and in the denominator, we have zeros, which determines this collisionless resonance. So this is our final results, but I will show you to show for numerical calculation use normalized quantities. They are shown on the right. This is capital omega corresponding to dimensional frequency, and capital P corresponding to dimensional wave vector. Also, what is important for us is the drift velocity, which is normalized to the Fermi velocity. As we are interested in instability regions, then we need to realize the C power density. And due to the tensorial properties of the dynamic conductivity tensor, shown in the upper formula, this is rather a linear combination, not purely quadratic expression, which also appears if there is no energy. So for us it's important the angle shown on the last line on the bottom of the slide, named beta. This is the angle between the AC current and the AC field, and this angle characterizes the energy induced in the system by the K dependence and the DC electric field. So for numerical examples, we use this experiment by Dar Silva from Pennsylvania State University, which has investigated current transport in dopplerography and numerical values of important parameters are shown here. But we investigated compared four different cases. One with no drift in the electric system, and the other with finite drift velocity, but with different direction of this velocity relative to the direction of the weight gravity. The first two are so that drift velocity is directed when it is finite along the direction of traveling of the AC wave. And the results are shown here. Here are presented two pairs of curves. The first two corresponds to zero drift velocity, and in this case both longitudinal along the k-dependent vector and transversal component are not zero and positive, so there is no instability in such case. But in the second case, when drift velocity is along the k-vector, one of them may be colored with green color, corresponding to longitudinal component, takes negative values in the finite frequency region, and this corresponds to Cherenkov instability shown here in the coordinate system. This is the angle delta between k vector and electric field polarization on vertical axis and frequency on horizontal axis. The angle beta, just to remind, this is the angle characterizes the rise of energy. The regions of instability are restricted with black solid curve, and the upper bound frequency corresponds as estimation shows about 7.5 terahertz. On the next slide, we show the appearance of another instability regions on the right boundary of this slide, corresponding to 1.5 in dimensional frequency and about approximately 17 terahertz. They are very narrow, but this instability region comes for negative signs of non-diagonal components of the real part of dynamic conductivity tensor, and they are shown with the frequency dependence on the upper part of this slide. These instability regions are completely associated with the high frequency collision with resonance in these systems. I should skip this. This is not correctly reflected, but I can just comment on the words. The drift velocity chosen here perpendicular to the direction of the traveling AC wave, that is equal to 90 degrees, then the Cherenkov instability just disappears, and we have only small narrow regions at the most upper frequencies corresponding to high frequency resonance. So we calculated also and analyzed the imaginary part, but this is goes beyond the time frame of this report. And one concluding note, if some components dynamic conductivity tensor goes to infinity due to very sharp high frequency resonance, then it indicates that in our theoretical model something is not included quite correctly. And we understand that this is completely associated with the specific linear dependence of the energy spectrum. Since in this case all electrons have the same velocity equal to the Fermi velocity, and they are resonant simultaneously. And how we can diminish this resonance? We can do it by twofold manner. The first is just to spread electron velocity over the energy band, and we can do it if we take into account the quadratic deviation of the linear spectrum as shown in the upper line, which is valid for the high energy electrons. In this case, the resonance, which corresponds to zero denominator of the basic power formula, is not so sharp, and instead of infinity, we just have the usual resonance term with finite width and height as shown on this both slides. Another manner to depress this very sharp resonance with linear energy spectrum is to take into account screening of charge carriers. And in our phenomenological model, the screening just means that electric field of a AC wave generates some additional electric charge, which produces additional electrostatic potential, and electrostatic potential induces additional electric field. And this electric field in the linear problem should be included in the total expression for the AC current density, thereby renormalizing the dynamic conductivity tensor. And this is the screening effect. The effect of screening taken into account is similar to the deviation of the electrons in energy from linear dependence. So in conclusion, we have studied frequency and wave vector dispersion of the dynamic conductivity tensor, which has been calculated and analyzed for doped graphene under a high DC electric field. We revealed that real part is non-zero outside the Dirac curve in the terms of frequency and wave vector of the AC wave. It diverges at the resonance. The deviation of the linear energy spectrum and screening modifies the dynamic conductivity tensor. In that, the observed divergence is replaced with finite resonance, with finite width and height. And also, we reveal some regions from certain field configurations that provides negative AC power density, thereby making possible electrical instability in the AC wave amplification. With this model, which we developed in this presentation, we succeed to cover almost entire terahertz divergence, starting from approximately a few terahertz to a few tens of terahertz. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Any questions? Any questions? Okay. We may. So we